Since this week I started reading the Old Testament, and whenever I read the Old Testament, I never had the feeling that the text speaks to me. Never had the feeling that it reflects my personal life. It wasn't like I'm reading in the New Testament. I read the New Testament, always have the feeling that God speaks to me. And this week I started with Genesis at the beginning, and we read about how God creates everything, and we read about how God creates us human. We read that He creates Adam, and He creates Eve in the image of Adam, even out of the rib of Adam. And they are in the paradise, and they have everything to live. They have enough food, and there's just one thing which they aren't allowed to do. That's one tree, the tree of life. They aren't allowed to eat from the tree of life, but they can eat from every other tree in the garden. That sounds great, doesn't it? They can eat from every tree in the garden except for just one tree. But then the serpent came, everything has changed. So the serpent asked Eve, "Are you really not allowed to eat of any tree in the garden?" And Eve reacts and repeats what God has said to her. "You aren't allowed to eat of the tree in the midst of the garden, near you shall touch it, lest you die." The serpent responds, "Your eyes will be opened, and you will be like God." So she still argues with the serpent. She could have run away to God, but she still stands there and argues with him. Then she looks at the tree and she saw it was good for food. It was a delight for her eyes. The same principle applies to us when we get tempted. And then Eve saw that the tree was good for food, and it was a delight for her eyes. The same principle here applies for us. Satan also tempts us. And we can decide if we argue with Satan or if we run away. So Eve started talking to Satan. And she had no chance because Satan is the crafter. It's way crafter. And the same principle applies to us. Satan also tempts us, and Eve started talking to Satan. She started arguing with him, and he's really crafty. When we argue with him, we can only lose. And the best is when we just run away, speak to God, but that's really hard, because we can't see that he's here, can't see that he feels what we feel. But what is when we didn't achieve that, didn't run to God, started arguing with Satan, and we sinned again? What should we do now? So first let's look at Adam and Eve, what they have done. So God went to the garden to see if everything is all right. And Adam and Eve start hiding in the garden because they were ashamed. And God speaks and asks, "Where are you, Adam?" The response, "I heard that you came to the garden, but I hid from you, because I'm naked and I feel afraid." And God asks him, "Who told you that you're naked? Have you eaten from the tree of life?" And then he responds, "The woman you gave me, she gave me fruit of the garden and I ate it." And whenever I sin, I'm often like Adam. I hid myself from God. But he is always there for us, like it stands in 1 John chapter 1 to 9. "If we confess our sins, he is faithful, just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness." Where can we apply from the story to our daily lives? We have to know that Satan is there, he wants to tempt us. We have to be careful, watch out. We can't start arguing with him, because he is crafty. We can lose when we start arguing with him. So we have to run to God and tell him about it. Like a little child who runs to his father, he has problems. We have to run to God. And when we can't do it, when we didn't make it, didn't run to God, we start arguing with Satan, we lose the battle. Then we can come to God and ask him for forgiveness. because he is always there for us and he knows about our loves.